Oklahoma has won the toss. They have elected to receive, and they have two of their most dangerous players back to receive the kickoff. Westbrook and Mixon, as both the quarterbacks are getting ready. D.D. Westbrook, number 11, averaging almost 38 yards a return. And he'll take it 8 yards deep and keep it there.
Games have been legendary for the Sooners.
Samaje Perine starts at running back, and it's a flea flicker. It's back to Mayfield. Now he's got to run for it, and it blew up in their face. Great job by Baylor. Blanchard and Smith got credit for that last sack. Perine straight up the middle. Lowers his shoulder and gets back past the original.
Sports with a tailback for Oklahoma. Both running backs back today.
Mixon is in now. Terrific receiver makes that catch, and he's got a first down up. He'll stay on the field as the tailback. And they throw to Basquin.
Learned a lesson last week, but he is really good in the open field and great hands.
Nice fake by Mayfield. Being pursued, throws. Caught! Jeffrey Meade. Terrific catch. Fake to Perine. And dropped inside the five up. Mayfield again as he comes out throwing. That one is too high to complete. Third and long. Mayfield with good protection floats this one back shoulder throw and has it complete to Andrews.
How by Andrews getting that to his left arm, and Oklahoma went fast so that there couldn't be a review.
From time rushing record by now. He's probably not going to make it with the time he's missed. Mayfield cuts to the outside and scores. 15 yards for Baker Mayfield. They had a blitz coming off the corner, and he beat it.
I tell you the nifty move here. This is a great play call. This was a run-pass option with a quarterback run. Was right at the end when he was setting up a block by D.D. Westbrook. He dipped to the inside and then went out to the outside. Very good run.
Seibert comes in for the point after. And Oklahoma obviously made the right decision in winning the toss and not deferring to the second half. This is a game where you want the ball if you can get your hands on it, and you want Baker Mayfield to end up with it if you can for the touchdown. McCaw their jobs. They lost half of the 2016 recruiting class because of it, and some of their veterans transferred. They called for an independent investigation by an outside law firm that made, as you see, his son Kendall, who's still on the staff as an offensive coordinator.
This week had to fly up to Indianapolis to talk about a recruiting violation, even though it was a minor recruiting violation, just more distraction playing and playing teams like TCU and Baylor. We need more focus from everyone, especially our assistant coaches. And
Cannon made that last catch, and Baylor, which has still this prolific offense, has more. Doc.
Yeah, I totally agree, Mike. I mean, character, integrity, ethics, everything for John Met this week. He said, we've got to focus. He said, I told our players, it's like a golfer who goes on to play golf.
Baylor is going for it. And they didn't get it. They didn't even get close. Jordan Wade stands him up in the middle of the play. Takes over on downs at the 47. Perine, the tailback behind Mayfield, and he'll get the call. Samaje Perine
struggled in slowing the run, and if Oklahoma is anything, they're balanced. They love to sling it, but they love to throw it, run it with Perine and Mixon as well.
Mayfield pulls it. A great escapability. Gets what he can and gets out of bounds. You talk
out balance. He was really special in the middle.
Third and five, four-man rush. Mayfield over the middle. That Flowers was.
This is bad news for Baylor. Shock Linwood, who is suspended, the Baylor all-time leading rusher, at home for attitude issues, and now Terrence Williams going off with what looks like a lower leg injury. That's bad news for Baylor in a couple of weeks of just tough on the field
Russell takes over at the 2 on the season. He's averaging more than 300 total yards a game. Also responsible for 27 touchdowns. And Cannon caught it, but the last two have come in the last 2 weeks.
And they went negative yardage on the first play, and now Dom D'Souza, the left tackle, backed up out of his stance,
full
and they're going to get a false start.
Offense, number 64, 5-yard penalty. It's second down.
Big throwing from the pocket here.
Oklahoma comes with a four-man rush off the weak side. The ball's batted down.
His jump, Russell maybe could have got a pump there.
Russell throws from his end zone, tipped it incomplete, too high.
Blockable.
Drew Gaelitz with Westbrook, who's averaging 19.8 a return, waiting at the 50. Has to signal fair catch.
Hey, I know that's a long shot, but you need some chaos in the Big Ten and the ACC.
And you need to root for a lot of people. Mixon just tripped.
From the NFL, he's their best player up front. That was a mash job.
Mixon again. No place to go. This time backs with Mayfield. They love to send Mixon out. They do this time. Instead, they'll throw over the middle. And it's complete.
Kingdom reached back and made the grab.
Mixon again. How's that for quick feet? Mayfield holds it as long as he can and throws another perfect strike. Touchdown! D.D. Westbrook somehow avoided the tackle and somehow stayed inbounds for a 29-yard score.
Mike, it's called athleticism. And I think Westbrook, well, that was a little bad technique there at the end on the tackle by Chance Waz. Waz got a little too high instead of going. Well, he got confused when Westbrook went down and Waz was playing so high. Well, that's a pretty good balance.
Keep going. Seibert, and Oklahoma jumps on top. 14-0 with 5:17 to go in the quarter.
They may have their struggles on defense with some injuries, but this is as good an offense as there is in the nation.
He could not bear weight on that right knee. Not good news.
Bad news just keeps coming for the Baylor Bears.
Speaking to the competition of Williams and Hasty, Jermichael Hasty, who's it now in as a running back well, and so Shaq Linwood is at home today. Lot to overcome.
Quarterback keeper's going to come up short as Russell was tripped by Caleb Kelly.
But I think this is a run even with Williams out.
Quarterback keeper again, and they've got it more to the 35.
And he nearly snuck through for 6.
Help me win a game.
Will do, sir.
That was Justin Cook, an 11-year veteran of the U.S. Navy, including serving time in Iraq. Selfless approach to life, serving as president of the Student Veterans Association. Hasty down to the 12.
We Taylor trying to make this a little competitive after picking up a key fourth down. Well, just
off the fingertips.
When he went
an eligible receiver downfield on the pass. Number 11 was covered by an outside receiver. The penalty is declined. Second down.
So second and 10. Flanker screen. And out of bounds. Russell fakes. Throws over the middle. Very dangerous throw, and it's picked off. Intercepted at the goal line as he pump fake and threw underneath Jordan Evans.
On at 14-7, instead it's 14-0.
Yeah, you wonder about the call as well. Throwing the ball at that point, pushing and shoving after the play. Mixon. He's got it all, doesn't he? Mixon again. Gets 2, maybe 3. P. Ryan, the 235-pound hammer of a running back, is back in. The throw to the outside will get him about 5 to Mayfield throws off his back foot, has the first down, and
nothing. Stick that one in there with back feet.
Mayfield after the fake. And that's going to be the end of a fun-filled first quarter from Norman, Oklahoma, where the Sooners have taken a 14-0 lead over the visiting Baylor Bears. Mayfield with split backs. Boy, has he been sharp so far. Piron caught in the backfield and taken down. Blitz coming. Mayfield again off his back foot. Floats it up for grabs and floated it perfectly to his guy, Mykel Jones.
And Riley, the offensive coordinator, is yelling, no. Yep, okay. All right, that's fine, because that's what you get with Mayfield. He will heave it up there, but he...
Piron to the four.
The level he's already playing.
Remember, it's not really important if I saw him, just that Baker Mayfield saw him. And Piron bowls his way in, and it's a 3-touchdown lead.
And give the defense credit, because for Oklahoma, everyone around here has been so up in arms about how bad their defense was. That was a 14-7 game.
We have played, however, some of the best offensive football teams in the country this year in this schedule. To give up a lot of points, especially in this league, is no sin. 21-0 Oklahoma as Piron caps a 91-yard drive. Guides, they always seem to change.
Well, for Sooner fans, it's how do we get in? They were in last year, very similar position this year. The big difference is the tough loss against Houston this season here.
Well, he's in his 18th year as Russell drives back to throw. He's going to have to take off. Stoops down his 18th year.
His career, he's won more games than any coach in the history of college in the first 17 years. And what's amazing, the state, very good teams. But the fan base, all they can talk about here is, we're so bad on defense. Non-conference teams that Oklahoma chooses to play every year. It's tough to keep them satisfied. Seasons as a head coach.
Just a remarkable level of success. And Russell is having to run for his life on every other play. Not anybody on earth for his institution while he's been here. That is such a rare combination.
Like what Nebraska does with their life skills, Oklahoma has a very robust. I start to feel like this is going to be a runaway, and their season may be slipping away as well.
Hasty again, nice cut, and got the first down to the 39. Terrence Williams was hurt at the start of the ball game, so unless they want to go deeper,
pass game, he just doesn't look comfortable. Looks like he's staring at some things and doesn't feel like he's in the flow.
Little option look, and Hasty again down to the 32. And
a receiver ran the wrong way on the wrong cut and got the pick.
Hey, Doc, isn't that always the case? You just the quarterback position takes the blame, staff, for the Baylor Bears come next season.
Got Blake Lynch, his first carry of the year as a running back. Now they go out in the flat, complete to Cannon.
The end of the first half, middle of the second quarter. This is pretty important.
Snapping fraction. Offense number 55. 5-yard penalty. It's first down.
Kyle said they checked him out, and he seems structurally stable, just a sprain.
This is the 15th play of the drive.
Catching some fumble, forced some fumble in the old break.
Russell crossing pattern, and he threw it behind Strickland. Certainly you wouldn't think of trying a field goal down here no matter what. Quarterback keeper Russell. And finally they blow it dead at about the 3. Flags down at the end of the play.
After the play, personal foul unnecessary, roughness, offense number 68. It'll be a 15-yard penalty. The down count.
Officials will let you push each other around a bit. You can't push somebody. You can't hit somebody in the face.
So now you've got to go with the field goal try. And Baylor at least gets on the board as Chris Callahan converts. 21-3, Oklahoma. Waiting at the five for Galen's kickoff. Westbrook dives out to the 25. And if it holds, it would be the best anybody has ever done in NCAA history. And he adds to it right there with Mixon coming across.
Pretty dialed in.
And he's run very well, too. Nice stutter step by Mixon to get him to the outside. Up to Mayfield, very good at those play action fakes for Westbrook. Tries to stay in bounds and get more yardages.
Patrick Mahomes, who are two future NFL quarterbacks, transferred here to Oklahoma, and now he's looking like an NFL quarterback.
He has now hit his last eight throws. Great kind of offense. You can get some quarterbacks. Nice move by Mayfield. Then the second man has him. He's still on his feet. Somehow stayed alive, throws it out of bounds.
Get out of that, but as
although
the
quarterback was out of the pocket, the pass failed to make it back to the line of scrimmage. Intentional grounding. Offense number six. Loss of down at the spot of the foul. Third down.
Very close to targeting there on Baylor.
Now third and very long for Mayfield. Throws it underneath to Mixon. One-on-one. Mixon gets what he can.
An opportunity to go for it.
Seibert hangs it up, taking it to 20.
Quarterbacks with recent history of Sam Bradford, Jason White. Been pretty great here.
What a catch. Not that.
Come on, let's go.
Boy, Russell taking a beating on some of these runs.
Why is that, Matt? He's been medically cleared to play, so. He certainly has not looked completely comfortable when he runs the ball.
That's Blake Lynch.
Put some things together, and this is an Oklahoma defense that has had its struggles.
Russell grabbed high and tossed
to be holding the ball a little bit.
Lynch again to the Oklahoma 48.
A little bit of some help for Jamarco Hastings.
Russell flanker screen. Zamora fumbled, recovered by Strickland. Fourth and two, no punt team. Lynch straight up the middle, he's got it. Moore, Lynch breaks a tackle.
21-3, got to get something here, right?
Complete to Cannon, breaks the tackle. Cannon, touchdown. Got away from Jordan Thomas, who was a big-time cover corner, but he couldn't make the tackle.
And it looked like the pursuit, you hear coaches talk about, we got to get 11 guys running the ball. It looked like the pursuit slowed down when they saw Thomas making the tackle. And when they got there, they were surprised that Cannon came free.
This is some response by the Baylor Bears. Down 21-0. They've scored on their last two possessions. This one, an 80-yard drive. And if it hadn't been for a really bad penalty, they had a shot at another touchdown.
And these two offensive series, very importantly, have given their defense a little blow, because in the first quarter, they had to defend a ton of plays, and against offense that is still one of the top 10 in the country. Comes to life, and boy, did they need it, especially for their defense.
Westbrook runs up on this one and is taken down just shy of the 25-yard.
You don't want a turnover. You've got this game in control. I think you can lean on the run game and use some of those timeouts if you need to.
Mixon. Nothing there, and a nice tackle by Avion Edwards,
the defensive coordinator.
Excuse me, that last carry went to Piron. This is thrown up for grabs and picked by Orion Stewart. Threw it into double coverage, and Stewart with his fifth, a team-leading total interception of the year.
That's right back on the field.
And Orion Stewart is a guy who can get from the center of the field to the sideline. And this pass almost Baylor could even get into position for a field goal. What a big lift it would give them going into the locker room. Russell on a keeper. Avoids his own man, dives forward. He's right at the sticks.
You're kind of behind the clock and the sticks because Oklahoma could have taken a timeout after that play if you don't pick up the first down.
Hasty.
So with those two timeouts, you can still be calling the run.
Oh, could have been caught by Strickland. A nice throw by Seth Russell. Hasty again. They come after him, and he kept it, but he lost it. Russell put the ball on the ground. Ahmad Thomas got it.
With three timeouts, let's see if they get aggressive.
Draw play to Piroff. Piroff up to the 41. Mayfield, pressure coming, throws underneath, in and out of the hands of D.D. Westbrook.
It helped Baylor a little bit. You know, it almost felt like Baylor would have let you run the clock off, and now you're still out here playing with some guys who can make huge plays when they need to. One game, and Terrence Williams went down on the first drive, and you and Jim Grobe are like thinkers, Mike.
Thank you. That's a compliment.
Well, they came. This was a really good performance by Baylor after a shaky game last week to go down 21-0 on the road and come back and make it competitive. Good for them.
It's 21-10 Oklahoma at the half. When we come back, the studio will bring you up to date on everything at halftime. Pick it away, levels, waits at the goal line. Takes it on the hop. And wrapped up.
It'd be 21-7 at that point.
A couple of plays could have really changed the nature of this game. Flanker screen.
They left Shaq Linwood at home for a suspension. The all-time leading rusher here at Baylor is not even here when they lost Terrence Williams to a knee injury on their first drive.
If we take care of the football, so we shut them down defensively late in the half, but we got to move the football offensively.
Well, you're right, Jerry. Complete pass to Strickland, and he breaks a tackle.
An eligible receiver downfield on the pass. Offense number 72. 5-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Seth, right guard Blake Blackmore.
More than 3 yards down the field. And here's another mental error.
Movement by the right tackle, Patrick
offense,
Lawrence.
Number 77. 5-yard penalty. It's first
now
down.
We should.
Beyond the line of scrimmage, and they have gotten a little tighter with that.
Flanker screen would have been a pick six right in the arms of Jordan Thomas.
This was completely jumped by Thomas, who just missed it.
This throw goes out of bounds.
Trying to get a block. Good read by the junior, Thomas.
Russell floats that, tipped and incomplete. Another opportunity to score.
All because of the pump that the quarterback had to double clutch it, otherwise be a whole different game.
Westbrook makes the fair catch.
To give you a key run block or pass block. Now you're run blocking. And that was just a huge penalty on Baylor. And again, not.
P. Ryan up to the 24 during town. And Ryan again, stoned the line of scrimmage
for Oklahoma.
Second and 9, Mayfield wants to throw, guns it over the middle of Andrews, and he's up to the 37.
Exactly. I mean, here he is right here. That's not a tight end position. That's a slot receiver.
Baylor shows blitz. They back off of it. Pass complete out of the backfield. So
he'll
three wides to the right. Yes, he will. He run good pass. Piron. Mayfield takes off, then throws. Back shoulder throw, Westbrook, touchdown. Mayfield has thrown two balls that didn't look good in the air, but he knew exactly what he was doing. He knew where he had to throw the ball to give his guy a chance.
Whew. What a great play on the ball. And And Mayfield now 2-for-1 on no, don't throw that. One, of course, the interception that he threw before the end of the half. The other one, a touchdown to Westbrook.
Seibert knocks it through. Westbrook and Mayfield with another huge game, and Oklahoma with a 3-score lead again. Beautiful campus of Oklahoma. This is kicking away. Levels. Tries to get outside. Breaks a couple of tackles, but a lot of Sooners there to defend in
Ohio State. It still gives you a better chance in college football playoff.
Jump time for Baylor. Hasty answering the call all the way up.
Holding. Offense number 77. 10-yard penalty. Repeat first down.
Yeah, they called a good game.
Russell on the slant. His crowd's been awfully quiet for a 28-10 lead.
That's early.
Russell, that was tipped and it's intercepted. Guess who? Jordan Evans. To the one. What a game he has had.
Senior year.
That's great. You can bet that's what he wanted to do from the time he could understand you'd go to school and play football, too. Direct snap. P-line. No signal yet. Now there is. Touchdown. It can be 99-yard drive or a 1-yard drive. They all count the same.
And a bummer for Baylor. Here's a team that really looked unfocused and not well prepared last week against TCU. They came in, they just got humbled early in this game.
That was your prototypical 4-second touchdown drive.
Well, we are in the Big 12. That's the way they roll here, Mike.
35-10 Sooners. Levels won't have a chance at this one. It goes at it
through a tough week last week and all the off-field issues that are going on. Just major life-changing thing.
Back with Jamichael Hasty early to a leg injury. Shot Linwood, who was their all-time leading running back, is not on this trip. And somebody does something that he thinks puts him in that category, he's going to call him on.
What a nice move by Hasty.
Russell too high on a slant.
Been in talking to him this week, taking this job, and his whole focus has been just try to get us focused enough and let these young guys who had nothing to do with what happened here have a good season.
Nice catch by Zamora. Afraid last week when there was a mass tweet from the assistant coaches in support of Art Briles. Has ever been around Jim Grobe knows how much he is respected and why. He is respected. He is a guy of the highest.
Penn State with the child molestation charges in Jerry Sandusky. And then, of course, the revelation. And Doc mentioned the Wall Street Journal report harmed by that behavior. That had nothing to do with it.
Fourth down. Big play here. And first down is Russell.
In the game, they checked his knee. It was sound. Just looked like a sprain.
Russell takes off again. Gets what he can, goes down about a yard shy of another first down, who has thrown 20 passes this year, completed 10 for 128 yards. That's it.
Ball start or snap? Illegal snap. Offense number 55. 5-yard penalty. Second down.
Throws deep, incomplete, and he was drilled.
To the head. But without Stidham, you get a true freshman in Zach Smith in without a chance, and who knows with a young guy.
Fourth down now. Go for it. Another flag.
Full start. Offense number 64.
Holy cow.
5-yard penalty. Fourth down.
Well, you know, you're so used to Seth Russell.
And it's back to a 4th-and-7 now. They want to throw for it over the middle, and they got the tight end Tecklenburg, and Tecklenburg, the big guy, at 270 pounds.
Wide open.
This one thrown in the flat. There was a lot of contact up.
Doing a good job fighting through and almost having an interception right there.
Williams reached out, tried to get the ball across the goal line, will come up just short.
Significant injury, so if he could go, they were going to let him.
Third and goal. Smith tries the quarterback keeper, did not make it.
Well, I think they're going to give a look. They haven't called it yet.
Touchdown!
Because, yeah, he looked like his momentum got in, and the line judge could not see and had to go take a look. Now, during that time, the line judge is running there, of course. You could always push the ball above, but that's impossible to see with that many bottles. So the line judge waited until he got inside to call it.
So how about that for the freshman? Mechanics and officiating. The umpire is a foot away from that, and he doesn't make the call. You wait for a guy who's 40 yards away to come running in from the sideline, and he makes the
offense,
call.
Number 85. 5-yard penalty. Try for point.
Another penalty.
And they do. 4:15 to go, third quarter. 35-17.
True. Chill and have dinner and not worry about football for a while.
Westbrook from the one. Doesn't make the 20. Good coverage. Oh, offensive unit. Mayfield so quick to get away from trouble. Gets what he can up there.
Sport, if you have a guy at that position like that, it really helps.
Mixon runs into Tyrone Hunt. Mayfield buying time now. He takes off. Slides in safely. Boy, Tony Nicholson is deep. And will make a fair catch at the 27. And
9 months before he got that job at Texas Tech.
Now, can Baylor put together another good drive?
When you can score in bunches, I know with Seth Russell out, if you're just joining us, unfortunately, in the ankle, just a horrific turn of events for Baylor at the quarterback position, and because
hard run fought forward for a first down, and that pass hit the ground incomplete
by the football team and athletic department, and the firing of Art Briles.
They were thrown by a step to Zamora.
There's a lot of questions, and it's going to result in poor performance on the field and recruiting.
Blitz coming, and they got him off the corner.
Defense in basketball before you make the tackle.
The other thing he didn't do was jump up in the air.
Yeah, get left.
Westbrook. So Mayfield will go back to work from the 20-yard line. Mixon. Boy, he is nifty.
He is.
Nice way to end the third quarter. Oklahoma. 35-17 over Baylor, going for their eighth win of the season. Sooners at the 36, first and 10. The clock is their friend. Let's see if they're a little run heavy here. Mixon gets five.
Against an offense that, while struggling, Baylor can score in bunches.
Option look, Mixon again. Mixon, first down and more. Got that burst. He's gone. 56 yards. Mixon is now over 900 yards for the season. 937, in fact, as he approaches that 1,000-yard barrier. That's
going to be, he's got to share time. He's got Samaje Perine to share time with, but Perine moves
and
on.
All Perine was ready to do was break Billy Sims' record.
Right, but now he's got to share. And you mentioned the burst. Watch right there.
Woo!
when he turned it on, he started walking away from the guys in white. Levels at the one. Taking that at the 20, flag is down as well. Thrown into the pile and pushing and shoving afterward.
Personal foul, block below the waist. Kicking team number 19, 15 yards added to the end of the run. First down.
Season is done. Replaced by Zach Smith, who throws a strike. And this is going to end up as a touchdown for KD Cannon. 62 yards.
And you know what? I want to give Stephen Parker, the safety here, who loses his helmet trying to make this tackle. Parker could have wound up and laid out Cannon on this. Instead, he decided to slow down and try to make the tackle. He could have gone for a blown up. You could see him pulling his head away. The only thing Parker didn't do was wrap up. And I know that will go down as a missed tackle. And I know that Parker should have made that tackle. However, because he went in with proper technique and didn't try to blow up the receiver, you have to give him at least credit for going through what he's been taught to do and not getting the penalty, because that could have been one of those leave your feet kind of blow up shots.
And if he scores, however, Westbrook with another chance for a return. And just tripped up.
Against Michigan down to the end, but for what it's worth, there's my top six.
Off a cliff.
The Ohio State one, not a big deal unless you're sitting there both with two losses against Ohio State. Then I think the committee picks potentially Ohio State.
With the clock running. Mayfield with time floats this, another back shoulder throw and another catch by Geno Lewis.
Usually the receiver sees the ball before the defender.
Piron.
Dana Holgorsen, the head coach at West Virginia.
And it's such great history when we met with Bob Stoops yesterday. Yeah, you should give him a try. And, of course, the rest is history.
Mayfield is split out as a wide receiver. Direct snap to Piron.
Bob Stoops, who you're looking to blame.
Piron again.
Said it was such a great experience and hurt his pride a little bit.
told him for a while. Mixon, look at this guy. This is a special talent.
He came all the way back to the Big 12 from East Carolina.
Mayfield swing to Piron.
And
well, Lincoln Riley.
Some other guys have done that.
Yes. Going into today, number three in total offense. Great fake by Mayfield on the keeper. Gets what he can and then steps out of bounds.
Really made a choice that goes against kind of the old thinking of, oh, I want a nice conservative offense. He immediately went when he got the job here and got
the players and the systems aren't good. Mayfield this time caught.
But you know what, Mike? Here's what, they're not going away from the run. The run is an incredible part of this game plan. And while they'll end up with crazy throwing numbers,
Mayfield quarterback draw. Got down to the four. Been terrific in practice. Hasn't really carried it over in games yet.
Just doing everything you can to jinx him, aren't you?
No, that was not a jinx stat at all. That, if anything, it was the other one.
And Joe shared with us, not announced yet, but phase four, they're going to put a roof on this place. That's a joke. A playoff for the second year in a row, and why it is so difficult is because the Big Ten is so good this year that there could be two teams out of that league in the college football playoff, possibly.
I think two losses would make it just almost impossible. Flag is down on this, probably going to be an interference call.
It's interference, defense, number 27, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
That was catchable, and if it's not, you call it off.
Smith has already shown us the big arm. He does again to Cannon. Excuse me, to Zamora.
And Zach Smith's going to get plenty of reps now. If you're just joining us, Seth Russell done for the year with what looked like a really significant lower leg injury. The investigation of said allegations properly. Still ongoing. What's going to happen here at Baylor? New athletic director Mac Rhodes has a big, big job ahead.
inside the 20 to Blake Lynch today.
They haven't had many good defenders here.
No. Boy, another pass just whistles off his hand. He's got Jamichael Hasty back there with him. Instead, he throws for the end zone and just a little bit too high.
There are people on, you don't have to sprint on.
That one's batted down to the line of scrimmage.
Defense makes a change on personnel. The defense can match it and a line.
Third down for Smith to the end zone. Back of the end zone. Cannon can't get it. Fourth and goal.
A lot of people in Vegas interested in this score, I think.
Smith with a pump fake, throws, and underneath they didn't get in. Down to about the 1 foot line, but they'll turn it over on downs.
That's coordinator here, of course. Sonny Dykes.
When they come off to the side of the field.
Oh, yeah.
There goes Pirine. Doesn't have the breakaway speed of Mixon.
Sip in a row. This team is red hot. This is a good
group.
They
have now two running backs who've gone over the 100-yard mark as Adams checks in.
Safe in the pocket. And I watched that first game of the year, the hits he was taking to his head and neck area. And I agree, Mike. I think that this, with the players changing their behavior.
Abdul Adams, they weren't sure he was going to be able to play. A little banged up after last week, but he drives forward and gets a first down. Jerry Punch, I wanted to ask you a question about that medical replay system. You said it's valuable in diagnosis. For example, if somebody is coming from one direction or another, is that what can tell you the extent of an injury?
Yeah, Mike, exactly. See behind me, they can rewind any of our previous plays and show exactly what's happening here. That way you know if a player is injured, how the mechanism occurred.
All right, thanks, Doc. Didn't mean to jam you on time there, but I wanted to have you explain that a little bit. Big win for Oklahoma, number 11 this week in the playoff rankings, certain to move up. 45-24, they win today at home over a game bought Baylor team that fought. For Ed Cunningham and Jerry Punch and our entire crew, thanks for watching, everybody. This is Mike Patrick. Now we send you back to the studio.